Those of you who attended our second annual Unity Health Fair remember Nick Edwards, the Pyramid Man. And I first met Nick in a wonderful meeting place, discount vitamin store, here in our area. And it's a great place. It seems like spiritual people network there all the time. And Nick Edwards is certainly part of that spiritual networking. So we talked, and he was a presenter at our health fair, and he has so much wisdom. And is just a fascinating person. And I would encourage you to go to his website, which is www.powerofpyramids.com. You'll find out a lot of things about the ancient Egyptians and his pyramid products that he sells. The biggest seller is fascinating. I'm thinking of this for the future, Nick, for myself, is a pyramid that you hang from the ceiling over your bed, you know, lifts your energy and does all kinds of great things for your health and your dream state. But Nick is our guest speaker today, and his lesson is about Moses and the Arkatron, the subtitle, Moses Had One and You Can Too, right? So can you? Come on forward, Nick. Thank you. Did you notice this? He'll explain. Do you have the mic?
I think so.
Right.
Hello. Very nice to be in this church. Have to admit, I've never gave a sermon before or talked in a church. So it's new for me, but I'm happy to be here. What you see here, this device, it's my latest invention. I'm sort of like a mad scientist. And I go through the Bible and I look for ancient wisdom. All my life, I've been interested in pyramids, and this is the type of pyramid that I manufacture. It's an antenna design. This can pick up energy like your TV antenna does, except this is what the life force or the God force looks like. And this is a model of the Cheops pyramid in Giza, Egypt. And it's a very incredible place because this pyramid in Egypt is the most incredible thing ever built on the planet. It couldn't be duplicated today. It's got 2,600,000 stones that fit together so well you can't stick a business card between the joints.
Wow.
And it has a lot of sacred geometry. It's actually a model of a hemisphere, half of a sphere. And it's like a lens. It's like a lens that focuses the life force, or like a lot of people have said, it's like the God force. Anything around a replica of the Cheops pyramid model, like this is, anything that grows faster, plants grow faster, water that's put inside the pyramid charges with energy, our bodies are 75% in water. You drink the water, you get healthier. I've had pyramids in hospitals, burn centers, surgeries for over 30 years. And the people heal faster and they have less pain. And if it's over your bed, you sleep more comfortable and you have very nice dreams. You wake up with a lot more energy. So in the Bible, it talks about in the Old Testament, the original or first altar of God. And if you read that carefully, you'll see that Giza is exactly where the Bible says the first altar of God is. So the pyramid could have been the first place for worship, and it could have been where Jesus and Moses were initiated into the higher consciousness or fellowship with God himself. Anyways, getting back into the Old Testament, I always wondered what these arks were, the Ark of Noah, the Ark of Moses. This is an ark. This is, by definition, a segment of a circle. And ARK, as the arks are called in the Bible, or ARC, as they're called today, is the same thing. I researched to the oldest dictionaries I could find, the downtown Los Angeles Library and the Huntington Library. ARC and ARC, ARK means only one thing, segment of a circle. So this device over here is a model of the Ark of Moses, the Ark of the Covenant. And I came upon this because I was reading about the Ark of Noah. Noah was given four distinct proportions to build his ark. And the biblical pictures you see of the Middle Ages, you see a big fat barge thing. And if Noah was supposed to keep these animals alive, the thing that you see in these medieval pictures wouldn't work. It would collapse, it would capsize, the animals would die. So what I did, after I discovered what ark means, I took a compass and made radiuses in these four proportions given to Noah. And lo and behold, if you go intersect them all like so, you come up with a hull that looks like a kayak. A kayak is the most stable craft there ever was for the water. The Eskimos stay alive in them because if they fell over into the ice cold water, they would die instantly. And every part of the Ark of Noah is a segment of a circle. So the water has the least resistance going around a perfect circle. It's a circle this way, a circle crosswise on top, and every direction. So that boat is the most stable boat they could ever have the animals on to keep them alive. So this led me to think, you know, maybe I should investigate Moses.